the tournament referee, in this case, Mike McAndrew, racks the balls. As you see Earl Strickland there getting himself psyched for the match. He does get focused.
Looks like it came up dry. All he can do here is hit the one and just hit it hard.
Mike Massey beat some big names to get here. He beat Jim Rempe, Earl Strickland in sudden death. He beat Earl in this tournament. Stayed on the winner's side. He also beat David Howard and Johnny Archer. Strickland and Massey were playing earlier in the tournament.
Did you see that shot?
Yeah. Cut that in. Cut the one ball in and now the two ball. But Earl ran out the rack and missed on the nine ball and gave it back. Yeah. And that's how Massey won and beat Earl Strickland earlier on in the tournament.
You know, I watched that match too, Kevin. They both played great. He's a little out of line. He's trying to figure out which way he's going to go to get position on the eight. He's liable to end up on top of it.
Now, that is not where he wanted to end up, is it?
No, it is not. Here, he has an option. He can go across the corner or across the side. He's... he may get to shoot again. I believe Earl will play rail first on this ball. He'll hit the rail right here and play the eight ball in the corner. No, he's jumping it.
Oh, he does take a jump shot. And what a shot it was. Earl Strickland, a jump shot to sink the eight ball.
Yeah, we're going to have to start calling him Air Earl.
And he finishes off. He takes a quick 3-0 lead. And let's take another look at that jump shot on the eight ball, buddy.
It was a great shot. He was just barely hooked by the nine, and he elected to go over the nine instead of going rail first and coming around for position. He went over the nine, knocked the eight in, and shot the long nine ball in. Great shot.
Back now to live action. Earl Strickland leads 3-0 with about 13 and a half minutes left in the first half of play. There's two 20-minute halves, 40 minutes of regulation, and he drops the seven ball in the side pocket. Mike Massey does.
Looks like he's come up dry again. It looks like that he can hit the one, but I don't believe there's anything he can do with the one. He may get to shoot again. He must have a bank shot.
Well, he did try the bank shot, but to no avail. That brings Mike Massey back up to the table.
Mike has to make his move now. He don't want to get too far behind. He needs to get right on out here. He goes from the... If he just gets position on the two ball right here, I don't see any problems.
Mike's biggest victory was back in 1982. He won the National Nine Ball Championships.
Has to make sure he gets out here. He has to get on the four. The six is a big ball on this shot.
He's also down three games. He doesn't want to go down four games here. Right. Strickland took an early 3-0 lead over Mike Massey.
He hit it right. He needs to drop just a little below the six, so he'll have an angle to come on down for the eight. It looks like he's hit it perfectly.
So Mike Massey gets one game under his belt. The score now is 3-1. We'll be back with more from Memphis. Comes back to the table. There is a 20-second shot clock.
Great. This is his problem right here. He has to be able to cut the one ball in the side pocket there and play position on that ball. He may have ended up with a nine-ball combination here.
He's looking at the 2-9 combination right there.
4-3 seconds.
Oh, he made the two in the side pocket and left the nine hanging, as you see there.
Shot he needed to make there.
Ooh, but misses the three ball in the top right corner pocket. That brings Mike Massey to the table. And with the nine hanging, they could take a shot at that at any time.
Right. Mike has a chance here to shoot the three in, come across table. Oh, he was dead straight in. Combination on the nine. Okay, he played this ball into the nine for the short win and quick game to get to the next game.
That he does. He has pulled within one. The score now is 3-2. Earl Strickland still in the lead. There's 5:57 remaining in the first half. The clock continues to run while the referee racks the balls. He's quickly racking the balls. Mike McAndrew is the tournament referee in this case. Earl Strickland is at the table. He gets 10 seconds to shoot from the time they lift the rack, and it took him 3 seconds from the time he pulled the rack up. I saw the shot clock on that one, buddy. This is a quick game.
Yes, it is. Okay, he has a problem with the two and the one here. The one does not pass by, so now he has to figure out something for the two.
And eventually the nine ball could be a problem with this layout.
Oh, man, he shot it in about a third of a pocket. He's going to have problems with this ball here. He's make the two. He's got to figure out a way to get around that to get to the three.
Wasn't too hard?
No, he came out of it pretty good. He's really happy with coming out of it like that.
Well, Earl Strickland has had to fight his way out of the loser bracket to get this far, and he's beat some greats to get this far in the tournament. He beat you, Buddy Hall. He also beat Mike Siegel, who you might often see here on ESPN, Steve Mizrak, and Johnny Archer. So four top players he had to beat in order to get, you know, to fight his way out of the loser bracket. He's been making great shots ever since.
He's a great player. He never says die.
Earl Strickland widens the margin now, 4-2 over Mike Massey. And there you see his wife, Lisa. They were married about a year ago.
That one ball shot that he made there, that's just an example of his shot making ability. He shot that in less than half of a pocket. Four ball right here with a one here. What he has to do is make a combination on the four in that pocket in order to give himself a clearing in order to try to run this rack. Now all he has to do, Kevin, I say, is just stay in line.
Take another look at that shot and see why he missed what looked to be an easy shot.
Right. What he done there, he was thinking too much about the five. You can do things like that when you're playing. He just overstroked it a little bit, took his eye off the three, looking at the five ball, and missed a three. It was a very big game, too. It would have been 4-3.
He could have pulled within one. But now Earl Strickland has the chance to widen the margin, go up three games over Mike Massey. He sinks the six ball in the corner pocket. Now shooting for the seven, and then only needs to finish it off with the nine, which, Buddy, will the nine give him any trouble on the rail like that?
Well, it's always a little bit of a problem if it's against the rail like this, but Earl's such a great shot maker, he'll probably knock this ball right on in.
Knock that ball right on in, he does. That makes the score 5-2 for Earl Strickland. There's over 6 minutes, about 6 minutes and 17 seconds remaining in the first half. We'll be back with more of the Pro. Welcome back to the Pro Billiard Tour on ESPN. Kevin Cusick along with Buddy Hall. And at the table breaking is Mike Massey. There you see the Miz, Steve Mizorak.
Well, he has two problems here. In this particular rack, he has the four ball, which he has to make get out of the way now. Then he has these two balls up here that he has to deal with. Now he has three balls in this area. He has to deal with the one to get to these three balls. This is really a problem here. I'd say he'll get to shoot this again.
He does. Earl Strickland comes to the table, one quick look, and gives the shot right back to Mike Massey.
Okay, he's shooting a jump shot here. Hit it well. He'll get it again.
And Earl decides to pass again. Mike Massey quickly trying to get his cue. He's got his jump cue coming out. He's down 5-2, so time is a factor now. There's just over 5 minutes remaining in the first half. He does use the jump cue, hits the one ball, but doesn't make a pocket.
Mike's confused.
Earl Strickland has now passed three times in a row, so Mike Massey will stay at the table. And the player does have a choice to shoot or pass. And Mike Massey makes a nice shot across table bank on the one ball.
He may have a cross the corner shot here on the three, or maybe even a billiard on the six. He could possibly play a billiard on the six.
There's a look at Francine Massey, Mike's wife. She's a photog for Pool and Billiard magazine. She also coaches Mike. She's got him on a very strict diet. He was complaining about that earlier. But it must be working.
I'm sorry, I couldn't contain my excitement. He kicked it in.
With shots like that. We tried a billiard on the nine ball.
Yes,
5-9 billiard. Unsuccessful, but very nice effort.
He had a two-way shot there, Kevin. He was playing the five ball and the nine ball. He missed them both about the same distance. Had he made one, he might have made them both. I believe he'll get shoot again.
Now they're talking about whether he's going to pass or not. He decides not to pass and take the shot.
Oh, he knocked it right in.
And a very nice effort. And what you didn't see there was Earl Strickland just slammed his stick down. He was very upset that he didn't get a shot at that ball.
The problem is he can't believe that Mike didn't give him the shot. And then he can't believe that Mike knocked it in and run out.
Right.
He's saying to himself right now, I know he should have gave me that shot.
Well, that was key because now Mike Massey pulls within two. The score now is 5-3. Earl Strickland still in the lead and a happy smile. I think that's the first smile we've seen on Mike Massey's wife, Francine. And understandably, he pulls now within two. He was down three games and at the table ready to break is Earl Strickland.
He switched sides.
Earl Strickland was coming into this tournament the seventh-ranked player on the Pro Tour. He won the 1992 McDermott Masters nine-ball champion. He was also 1990 and 91 world champion. At the table now is Mike Massey.
He pretty much just has to stay in line here. He can just stay in line. I don't see any problems. Maybe the six to the seven might give him a little trouble, but I don't see any problem at all.
We're under 2 minutes. There's about a minute 45 remaining now in the first half of play. That's why you might see Mike Massey a little jump in his step. Well, it could be the 22nd shot clock as well, buddy.
Right. If he can win this game, now it's 5-4 at the half. He's very much in the hunt. He could have really been way out of this match. That shot on the five ball might have saved him the whole match.
And he did elect for a second there. He thought, maybe I shouldn't shoot this. I bet he's glad he did now. Well, got the 7, 8, and 9. He's got a minute left now in regulation in the first half, that is.
Right. When you've got two great players like that and one player is two or three games down, they know the only way they catch up is to shoot. So they'll take a tough shot sometimes if it'll get them back in the match. That's what he elected to do. And that's what happened. He's back in the match.
Yeah, paid off. He's within one. The score now is 5-4. There's 36 seconds remaining. And Earl is complaining about the clock. He called timeout. He wanted a timeout. He had like 3 or 4 seconds ticked off the clock. And now he's given the scorekeeper, or the timekeeper, Rick Fryer, a tough time. Earl will give anyone a tough time if things don't go his way, won't he?
He says it's my option.
Now he calls time in, as he should. Earl's a quick study, and he knows the rules, but... Now Mike Massey calls his timeout. They each get one timeout. Both used them very wisely here in the first half. There's 29 seconds left. And Mike Massey gets cue ball in hand because Earl Strickland fouled on the break.
Well, here, Kevin, what he's wanting to do, he's wanting to make sure that he gets out this game. If he gets out this rack, he's got 29 seconds left. Now, if he feels like that he can, he's got to know that he cannot run 9 balls in 29 seconds. So he's playing a combination on the 9 ball to try to tie it up.
No, he didn't play the combination.
He was playing to the combination, 2-9 combination.
He certainly left the cue ball in good shape to do that, but he didn't sink the 1 ball.
Right. It looks like they're going to go to the half at 5-4, unless he makes this billiard.
He gave it a ride, and he does! Earl Strickland makes it exciting. And they're not going to half at 5-4. They're going to half at 6-4. Earl Strickland will be back with the Q-tip right here.
To represent the United States, Team America traveled from country to country competing against the best they had to offer. Now you can own the collector's edition of Team America versus the World. 8 complete matches on 4 tapes. Order now at the introductory price of only $19.95 for each tape of 2 one-hour matches, or the complete set of 4 tapes, just $74.95. Call 1-800-257-8889. That's 1-800-257-8889.
Pool's leading tournament and money winner. Mike Siegel's new video shows you the champion's way to win. Perfect 9-ball, 8-ball, straight pool. You'd expect to pay up to $29.95 each. For a limited time, the series is just $9.95 each. All 3 on one tape, just $29.85. To learn how to play the world's best perfect 9-ball, 8-ball, and straight pool, order now and get Mike's bonus, 12 great trick shots.
Hurry, limited quantities available. Pick up the phone, order now. 1-800-776-8400. 1-800-776-8400.
Q-tip of the week.
Hi, I'm Jim Rempe from the Pro Billiards Tour, and I'm going to demonstrate the draw shot to you. The first thing you want to do when you address the cue ball on this shot is make sure that the tip of the cue stick is up against the cue ball and your elbow is straight up and down with your hand. The next thing you want to do is aim low on the cue ball, lock in your shoulder, and make sure you use just your elbow on this shot. This is just for a short draw. When you strike the cue ball, the tip of the cue stick will go down, and the cue ball will draw right back at you.
Tune in next week for another Meucci Q-tip.
How's the big guy got time for pool? Easy, we're delivering all the gifts. The 1991 and 92 editions of the Challenge of Champions Collector's Video Series. Highlights of billiards' most prestigious $50,000 winner-take-all shootout are available now for the first time. Either edition is just $24.95, or get both for just $39.95. Anyone who likes pool will love them, and if you call now, you'll have them within 10 days. Call 1-800-845-9000 for the easiest shopping of the season.
Zip code.
All-Pro quarterback Dan Marino.
When the game is over and the pain starts, I want fast relief and no odor. So I use Sports Cream, a strong pain-relieving rub that doesn't make me smell like a medicine chest. Sports Cream, fast relief and no odor.
You're watching Meucci's Pro Billiard Tour Championship on ESPN. We're at Cook Convention Center in Memphis, Tennessee. And at the table now is Earl Strickland. He's the number 7th ranked player on the Pro Tour. He's leading 6-4 over Mike Massey. And Buddy Hall, sum up the break for me.
Okay, well, he pocketed the ball on the break. He's got a tough shot here. He can play the one ball in the upper, the one ball in this corner pocket here with the three ball is here. That's the ball he has to play position on. It's tough to get there. He's ended up with a real thin cut shot on the three. He's a great shot maker, though. He'll just come straight back down table and play the four in the same pocket, I thought. I think he overcut the three.
Great predictions, but there's so many different ways that, so many different options, it seems, in this game, Buddy.
Well, what I think he done, actually, is overcut the three a little bit accidentally. And that's why he went into the four.
And a disappointed look on Earl Strickland's face brings Mike Massey back up to the table. He's called Tennessee Tarzan, and he is a big, powerful guy.
Ooh.
Mike Massey missed a similar shot in the first half on the three ball, and now he missed what seemed to be an easy shot on the four ball.
When you hit a ball that hard, you have to hit it so with such a degree of accuracy. If you miss it just a hair off the center of the pocket, you won't get the ball. He hit the pocket, but he didn't hit the center of the pocket with it.
Well, Earl Strickland missed on the four ball, and Massey gave him the shot right back to give him another shot at it. He elected to pass.
Well, now he's created a real problem for Mike. Well, he's created a real problem for himself. Here, you have the 5-8.
Well, they're tied to pass. Up. Now, Earl Strickland
he has to shoot this four ball in and figure out a way to get to these balls right here.
Nearly scratches on the cue ball. Brings Mike Massey up for a look. I don't know if he'll shoot or not. He can pass, and he does.
Earl may elect to play this ball off of the 5-8. He may bank this straight back and play him off the 5-8. That's what he tried to do. He just happened to miss it.
Oh. And he lucked the five ball in the top left corner pocket. And, Buddy, is there any trouble spots from here on out?
I don't see any problems. If he just gets on the seven ball, he's a little out of line on the seven, but he's such a great shot maker. He'll probably just shoot this in, come across the table for the eight. I don't see any problems.
Just about 3 minutes have elapsed in the second half here. There's a look at Lisa Strickland, Earl's wife of about a year, recently married. And Earl Strickland goes up 7-4 over Mike Massey. Mike Massey really needed that game. He's got some time left, but a score of 7-4, you don't want to get down too far because not only are you playing against your opponent here, but the clock becomes a factor.
Right. Earl had a very high percentage shot banking that four ball off of the 5-8 to make it in the corner pocket. He didn't make that shot, and he was very fortunate to knock the five in, giving himself a three-game lead, and now he's got Mike in the hole. Well, here, I think he's going to have to use his jump cue. He may kick at it. I would use the jump cue if I were that far behind.
Mike Massey shooting at the one ball.
Oh. Okay.
And he makes it.
Right. All he has to do here is stay in line. If he can get position on the three ball, just a question of staying in line now. Don't get behind anything.
There you see the three ball.
Three. He has to get position
on the four, all the way up table.
On the four ball, that was all over this ball here. Now, all he has to do now is just stay in line.
There's one of the great pros on the tour today, Jim Rempe from Scranton, King Pennsylvania. James. King James, as he's known, right?
He done it the right way. He made sure he got down on the seven. He's got to win this game.
I like Mike. Well, I hope she does. She's his wife, Francine, and his coach, and she's also a photographer for Pool and Billiard magazine. So Mike Massey has a chance here to come within two. He does. Score now is 7-5. Earl Strickland still in the lead. This has been a great tournament. It really has. Bob Meucci's put on a great tournament down here in Memphis, Tennessee. Good crowd here for the second semifinal.
Oh, this is where Earl excels. Here's the two ball. He hits these shots with such a degree of accuracy. The long range shot. He's such a great shot maker. Him, the likes of Mike Siegel and Johnny Archer, those guys make those shots with such a degree of consistency.
Buddy Hall. Can't you leave yourself out of there, buddy? Not after some of the things we've seen you do here on ESPN.
Okay. He has a 4-9 combination here. He's got to try to make it right here in this corner pocket. Which he...
And that he does. 4-9 combination for Earl Strickland. That gives him an 8-5 lead over Mike Massey. We'll be back with more of the Pro Billiards Tour on ESPN. Stay with us. Tour, love Lori John. Well, there's Sammy Jones, one of the members of the Pro Tour. And Lori John, his wife, of course, who's one of the great women shooters in the game today. And he wants to say a special hello to her back home. She's home with their new child.
Oh, big shot, big shot. He's got to do it again. He's trying to kick this ball in. This is the two right here. He's got to make something happen by hitting this ball and get...
Oh, he nearly did. He hit only the two ball.
He may get another turn.
Oh, he was trying to talk it in the pocket there. You see a lot of golfers talking to their ball when it's about 2 inches away from the hole. He was doing the same thing there.
He's getting another opportunity.
Earl Strickland decided to pass and give the shot back to Mike Massey. He shot it. Gave it his best effort. And back to the table now is Earl Strickland. He's looking it over, and he will decide to shoot.
Boy, yeah, this is a big game here. If he can win this game, he could be right back in the hunt with about 11 minutes to go.
The winner here will go on to play Roger Griffis in the final of Meucci's Pro Billiards Tour Championship.
He's got to jump the ball.
Ah.
What a shot. What a great shot. He had to go over the side of the nine ball in order to make the four and still do that with accuracy to play position. It's one thing when you start going to the airways, but it's another thing to play position and do that.
He's trying to pull back within two, buddy. And he really needs this game. The clock is now starting to work its way down. We're about 11 minutes left in the second half. And he's got one ball left. That's the nine ball. Right. 8-6 is the score. And that brings Earl Strickland to the table. And Mike Massey, he's one of the great trick shot shooters of all time. He's within two. And he does, like I say, spend 12 months a year on the road. I asked his wife where their hometown is now, and she said, we're gypsies.
His trick shot expertise showed up on that four ball. Now he jumped over the nine and played position.
There's Roger Griffis. He's anxiously waiting here because the winner of this match will play him next week on ESPN for the championship of the Meucci Pro Billiards Tour Championship. And Earl Strickland now shooting on the one ball. Makes it down in the lower right corner pocket. And, buddy, where's he going to go with the two?
Okay, he's going to play the two straight in. His problem lays right here with the six, the eight, and the seven. He's got to drop below. If he he has to drop into this area right here with the cue ball.
Just under 10 minutes remaining in the second half, 8-6. Earl Strickland, the player at the table right now, is leading.
He elected to get to play the bank shot.
Buddy, we've seen some great shots in this format, a very aggressive format in the sense that there's no safety play, and there's a 20-second shot clock.
Right, we have the 20-second shot clock. It's total offense, and now we're getting to the point of the game to where the shot clock really means something. Now, to use the clock to your advantage, to play your whole 20 seconds, or to speed it up in order to get as much out of your 20 seconds as you can.
And we saw Earl Strickland do that last week when he beat Dennis Hatch.
He's taking it all the way down. He's going to shoot this
4 seconds.
2 seconds left on the clock.
2 seconds, it was, right. Left on the clock. He's going to use up the clock, and why not? So Earl Strickland takes a 9-6 lead over Mike Massey. Mike Massey trying to get the balls out of the pockets as quick as possible because the clock does continue to run while the balls are being racked.
Strickland leads 9-6.
Sinks one ball on the break in the lower
right
left corner
here
pocket.
Is the five ball. It has no pocket up here. The only pocket it has is down here. He may elect to try to play for the 5-7 combination. Depending on where he gets here, he has no choice. He has to either play for a bank or play for the 5-7 combination. Oh, I don't know how he's ended up here. He may have a bank shot.
Banked in the five ball on that one. That brought Earl Strickland out of his chair.
Right, but he's hooked himself. Now what he has to do is try to kick the six in. He hit it on the right side. It just didn't go in. Well, this is pretty much basic pool here. Just don't get careless. Knock these four balls in. Take a four-game lead.
Just over 7 minutes remaining in regulation time. Earl Strickland is now up 9-6. He's looking at the clock, buddy, right? He's going to take all the time. There's a 20-second shot clock while you're at the table, 25 to the incoming player. So he's got 20 seconds here between shots. And he is going to play the clock. It's like the old UCLA days when they used to play the zone and eat up the clock in basketball. 4-3-2, and he shoots with 2 seconds left, and that puts him on top. 10-6 over Mike Massey. We'll be back with more of the Pro Billiards Tour on ESPN. Stay with us.
Meucci Custom Cues, the cue choice of more players worldwide today than all other brands, presents this beautifully crafted cue designed exclusively for World Team Billiards. For the first time on...
Welcome back to Memphis, Tennessee, home of the Blues. Kevin Cusick along with Buddy Hall at the table now is Mike Massey. And he breaks and nothing drops on the break. So that brings Earl Strickland back to the table. Earl is leading 10-6.
It's pretty much just stay in line here. Get a shot on the four. He played for a little angle to the inside of it. He'll play the four ball up in this upper right-hand corner, and it's clear sailing from there. Like I say, all he's got to do here is just make sure he doesn't make any mental errors. Just go ahead and play good basic pool. Take what you have and just knock the balls on in.
Well, Earl has won 3 championships already this year. He beat Johnny Archer at the LA Open in April. He also won the 92 McDermott Master 9 Ball Championship. He beat Jose Perica there. And he won the 92 Akron Open. It was his 8th time winning that tournament, buddy.
Yeah. They used to call him Mr. Akron.
I can see why.
He won it 6 times in a row once.
There you see the shot clock, about 5.5 minutes remaining. And an anxious look on the face of Mike Massey. All he can do now is sit and watch as Earl Strickland goes up 11-6 over Mike Massey. And that's the one tough part about this sport, buddy, is the fact that when the other player's shooting and he starts to run out, there's not much you can do. Although in this scenario, loser break does help.
It sure does. But the pool players have a word for that. They call it the electric chair. When
yeah.
they're sitting over there,
and it's pretty
they're
close,
sitting huh? in the electric chair. All I can do is sit there and pray.
Well, I hope the results aren't the same, because no matter how hard you play, you pray in the electric chair, the result is always the same.
Yeah, well, that was just a figure of speech, right? Here, all he has to do is play good basic pool here. Don't try to get fancy. Don't try to do anything out of the ordinary. Just play good solid pool. Got a long way to go here. He this is a little out of line here. He's got a long way to travel with the cue ball. He's gonna have to go to the side rail, the end rail, and back down. It's a tough shot. He played himself out of position. He got a little careless. When at this time in the match, you should never do that.
Not when you're down five games.
Right.
Over one of the great shot makers in the game today. You just can't give that kind of space to Earl Strickland. So Earl Strickland now 12-6. He has a six-game lead over Mike Massey.
He knows now that he doesn't have to watch the shot clock. It's out of range. He feels like that he's got this match won, so I'm just going to clear sail here and just make a ball here and there and run up the clock that way.
Makes a couple nine balls on the break.
That's his chance. That is his chance. If he can
his
make a nine
chance.
Ball on the break, every time you make the nine ball on the break, you get to break them again.
Right.
I had a man make six times in a row on me once.
The nine ball on the break six times in a row?
Six times in a row. It sounds unbelievable, but it can happen.
Huh? You probably still beat him, though, buddy.
Not that set. Earl's freewheeling now. He'll just knock this two ball in, draw his cue ball back down around the five, maybe a little below it, maybe a little over it, maybe behind it.
Earl is on cruise control now. He's got that very focused look in his face that we've seen here before on ESPN, and we get that look. He is like a machine gun, shot after shot after shot after shot. He just keeps making them. Earlier this year on ESPN, Johnny Archer unfortunately saw that look in his face on the LA Open out in Los Angeles and finished as the runner-up to Earl Strickland.
This match is all over but the champagne.
Well, there's a minute and 9 seconds left on the clock. There you see a shot, and Mike Massey's at the table now, shooting at the five ball.
Oh, man, what a great shot.
Combination into the eight.
Yeah, but where he made it from. He was jacked up over the six ball, one end of the table to the other. That's a great shot. It's really a bad feeling from here to know that, you know, it doesn't hardly matter. It doesn't matter what you do now. You just do the best you can. There's no hope now. You're six games down. There's 12 seconds left, 25 seconds left.
There you see the shot Shot clock 17. The match time 20 seconds left in regulation time. For another one. But Mike Massey calls timeout with 8 seconds left, so there will be time for another one.
Maybe don't break 5 times one time. I only got one.
Right, that's a good idea. But, you know, that is his last dying
guess.
Absolutely.
He can make it 13.
Just one, though, right? One timeout.
Just one timeout per half.
Nothing can help it.
Right, no.
Nothing can help it.
One timeout per half. Oh, Mike Massey, a true champion. He's going to give it his last shot, even though there is 8 seconds left. 3, 2, 1. And that's the end of regulation time. A handshake to the champion. And the champion in this case is Earl Strickland. A well-deserved victory, 13-6 over Mike Massey. We'll be back to wrap it all up. We'll talk to both the players when we come back. Stay with us right here on
my fellow touring pros, and we'd like to invite you to join us on the Pro Billiards Tour. For the first time ever, you can become an associate member of the Pro Tour. Here's how.
To order your tour membership, call 1-800-225-1234. You'll receive Pro Tour credentials, the Pro Tour monthly newsletter, and other fabulous membership benefits.
So call now to get rolling on the Pro Tour.
Billiards Tour on ESPN. I'm joined now by Mike Massey, the runner-up, and Earl Strickland. He's on his way to the final. But first, Mike Massey, you played a great tournament. Congratulations, first of all, on that. Secondly, it seemed as though you dropped off a little bit in the second half. Did you get a little discouraged there when you were down?
Yeah, a little bit. But I kept trying to fight back. You know, you got to keep, you know, like Earl's a great fighter. You know, you got to keep going. So I was a little discouraged, but I kept trying to hang in there, you know. And I'm thankful I'm here, you know.
Okay, well, you had a great tournament here in Memphis, and someone who continues to have a great tournament. First of all, this match, you really took off early, and you traded the lead back and forth, but then you really took off in the second half. It was all you.
Well, I think the momentum was to my advantage because I just got done playing, and Mike had to sit a while. But Mike played a heck of a tournament all week. My congratulations to him. He put me in the loser side. But I'll tell you, he played great all week, and I got a few better rolls than him, and he missed an early crucial shot. And the shot in the second half, when I lucked the nine ball, that was a big shot, too.
The shot making here, normally some of the players say your first thought is your best thought looking at the table. You were taking about maybe 5 to 6 seconds averaging per shot. Do you like to shoot that fast? We've seen you shoot fast before, but you were shooting even faster tonight.
Well, I think I'm overreacting a little bit. You don't have to play that quickly, but I feel like the more time I got, the more chance I got to win. So I want to keep more time on the clock, and maybe I can get a chance to win that way.
Okay, Earl Strickland, congratulations to you. From all of us here in Memphis, Tennessee, for Buddy Hall, I'm Kevin Cusick. Thanks for joining us.
This program has been brought to you by Meucci Originals, custom pool cue makers, the choice of champions worldwide, and co-sponsored by Gandy, the pool table choice of the Pro Billiards Tour Championship, and Cue Gloves by Sir Joseph. They let you enjoy the game more.